Namaskar, I am Dinesh Vohra. This is the Daily Spice channel, the associate channel of News Time. All people are aware that we are presenting a series on the Bangladesh, and this is the English version of the programs which are being presented on the News Time channel. Today in this series we are going to present something very different, a comparison between Bangladesh and Pakistan. But this so-called comparison has never been discussed before on any of the YouTube channels. This comparison is different in many ways, because most of the commentators, when they compare the Bangladesh with Pakistan, they compare the economy, the military strength, and lot many other factors. But I'm not going to discuss those things today, at least in this particular issue. Here I am going to compare the two things which makes a nation great. Why a nation goes down and why a nation goes up. Why Pakistan is consistently coming down and why Bangladesh is just going up and up. What are those reasons? I am a management expert. I am a management faculty. I teach MBA students in various colleges and universities. And today I'll be comparing Bangladesh with Pakistan from management angle. That what makes the Bangladesh different from Pakistan. It is something like some comparisons are being carried out in the top level universities also. So from this angle, I have chosen few factors. Apart from these factors, there can be many other factors, but I have chosen around 8-9 factors through which we will be trying to compare these two so-called countries and their government and attitude of citizens. The very first factor, the management factor, which comes to the picture is positive attitude and self-esteem. Now, positive attitude is something, is one of the most talked about, most discussed topic in the world. It is being taught from the, you can say, childhood stage, in the schools, in the colleges, in management institutes, in corporates, in government. And this positive attitude also means that people are willing to take the initiative and go ahead. This is the positive attitude which enables the people to plan properly, organize properly, and then implement the things. Now here I have found in last 20-30 years that there is a sea change in the attitude of people of Bangladesh. Pakistan is going down just because it has not been able to generate a positive attitude in themselves. Neither the government has got that positive attitude and constructive attitude. What I call a three phases of attitude or three types of attitude: positive attitude, productive attitude, pleasant attitude. Three P's. I don't find these three P's, the positive, productive and pleasant, in Pakistani government or so-called their people. That's one reason that these so-called Pakistani economy is going down and their progress and growth is also going down. Nobody is believing them. Nobody is even willing to give them loans also. They are almost a bankrupt country. Whereas Bangladesh had all these things. They are positive, they are productive, they are pleasant. Their government is also following these three P, and their people also follow. So that's one reason their self-esteem is higher, the way they think, the way they feel factor. Self-esteem means the feel factor. And their feel factor is very high. Their motivation is very high. So that's how the positive attitude, pleasant attitude and productive attitude in Bangladesh people is far superior now comparing to the Pakistani people in general. Second most important factor which differentiates between the people of Bangladesh and Pakistan is the level of self-belief. Now this belief has taken the Bangladesh to sky-high limits. They have become the world's almost leading garment exporter. And their garments are going to various countries, developed nations, in each departmental store, big stores, Walmart and Marks and Spencer, and everywhere they are available. Last year I was in Australia and I had gone to many showrooms, and you should not be surprised that very large number of counters were there where the most of the the trousers and shirts and t-shirts and other kind of, you can say, these garments are all had the labels made in Bangladesh. I could not found a single one from made in Pakistan. And even I bought those shirts and the so-called garments there. And you'll be pleasantly surprised today that shirt I'm wearing today, this white color shirt, is also I bought in Australia in Melbourne. And that's also made in Bangladesh. It has got fine texture, very fine stitching, and I love to wear it. So the self-belief is very high in Bangla people. They know they can conquer the world, they can conquer the market. Whereas such self-belief is absolutely dismal and low in Pakistani people. They are unable to export the things and they are just simply importing. Nothing is being produced there. So they are a society which is continuously going down. Nose diving is there. Nobody believes a Pakistani person. Even I tell you, the condition of their passports is so bad that recently there was a ranking of the passports in the world, and Pakistani passport is ranked in the bottom five countries. It means the moment a Pakistani person goes abroad, none of their fault of course, but when they show their passport to the immigration officers, then the people there in the immigration bench, they have a something like they frown on that one, and they don't like the Pakistani you can say traveling to their countries, and immediately they raise the suspicions and doubts. Whereas whenever an Indian or a person from Bangladesh reaches the other countries, immediately there is a smile on the face of immigration officers. So that is a respect. This respect is due to self-belief that you are doing something constructive, something productive, something pleasant, something positive. Another factor apart from self-belief from the management is the great vision. How people can see the things. While Pakistans are nose-diving right now, unable to have a vision for themselves in the next 20, 30, 40 years, whereas the Bangladesh has a great vision that we will be achieving something. Now recently when the report came that the Bangladesh will be $1 trillion economy by the 2033, and it created a lot of good sensation in Bangladesh. Even I did a program on that one. But now with the growth of 8% plus, I believe that $1 trillion economy can be reached by 2029 or 30, at least 3 or 4 years before that. And this I am saying as a management expert. This I am saying as a person who has some authority and understanding of economic matters. So this is due to the great vision. So vision the Bangladeshi people have and vision the Pakistani people have. Rather, Pakistan do not have any vision right now. Whereas India and Bangladesh both have great vision for the future. Another important factor which differentiates the Pakistan and Bangladesh is level of communication and public relations. At the world level, at the domestic level, their communication is strong, communication is effective, communication is efficient. Whereas any statement given by the Pakistan or Pakistani people is not being believed by the people outside the world. They have lost the trust. They are not trustworthy people as government now. Whereas the people from India and Bangladesh both are trustworthy and their communication is very strong and efficient. And I'll appreciate Bangladesh for that. Another management factor which comes between the huge difference between Pakistan and Bangladesh is level of commitment. The people in Bangladesh are greatly committed to their cause. And you see, this commitment, this zeal, this initiative is taking them top. Look at their cricket team. Now it's beating the world-class teams. It's going up, where the Pakistan cricket team is coming down. So it means the level of commitment in Bangladeshi people is much greater. They know if we have to supply the things at the world market, it has to be top class. And they are doing it. And they are getting the appreciation. And top traders in this world, they are opting for the pharmaceutical goods from Bangladesh, IT, then garments, then even marine products, a lot many other things which Bangladesh is exporting right now. So they have the trust, and this trust is coming from their commitment. And this commitment is not being seen in Pakistan right now, neither in government nor in people. Next factor is initiative. Bangla people are taking initiative. They want to create opportunities. They want to lap up opportunities. They see the opportunities. In Pakistan, it is not so. Bangla people right now are creating the opportunities where none is existing. I did a program on the shipping, and they were a, Bangladesh were a ship breaking country primarily, but now they shifted from ship breaking to ship making, whereas Pakistan, nothing is happening. All industry is in shambles. No government support, even people are frustrated. So that's the difference. Then one more thing which are very important from management angle is resolve and determination. The resolve and determination of Bangla people is at least 100 times more than the Pakistani government and their people. And this determination is making them a great nation. That's how maybe in just very short span of time, the Bangladesh will become the top level economy in the top 25 of the world. And that's a moment of great pride. Then one more factor from management is the people in Bangladesh are greatly motivated to do the things. In Pakistan, they are dejected and frustrated. They have lost the self-belief. They have lost the positive attitude. They have lost the self-esteem. They have lost the sense of determination. Whereas in Bangladesh, the people are greatly motivated to do the thing. And they want to achieve at the earliest. If I tell them that you have to achieve in the year next 10 years, they say, no, we want to achieve in 5 years. So that is the determination. That's I want to see in them. And last one, the Bangla people, they got independence in 71. They know how to make their destiny. Pakistanis have forgotten how to make the destiny. They are trying to destroy their country and destinies. Whereas Bangla people are resurrecting them from ashes and then trying to resurrect to make their destiny as a top class nation. And this particular feel factor, they know how to do it and they are doing it. Pakistanis speak, Bangladeshis do. This world respects only those who do the things, not just speak. That's one reason the people who do things, their work speaks. That's one reason the Bangladesh is becoming a superior economy, a superior country. So it's Bangladesh right now is 20 to 30 years ahead of Pakistan in every aspect. And in management factors which I have counted, here Pakistan is non-existent, whereas Bangladesh is everywhere. So my greetings to people of Bangla. They have done tremendously well. They have made it as a Amar Sonar Bangla. They have converted into this Sonar Bangla. And they deserve the greetings. And I, as a fellow Indian from India, I appreciate them for their grit, their determination, their positive attitude, their commitment, their initiative, their focus, and so-called their great vision and self-belief that they can do it. So I'm very happy for their progress. In this issue, only this much, I'll request all people to subscribe to this channel, Daily Spice. This is the channel where this Bangla program is being presented in English version. And also you can subscribe it, those who are not subscribed, and press the bell button so that every time the video is uploaded, it reaches you immediately. So all this is here in this issue, and very soon we'll be coming out with a new issue on Bangladesh. So till then, wait. So thank you very much for being with us. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.